Sin could be all kinds of incredible. And worth noting, as Chaz plays his last game of MSI 2021, three straight Victor games. Hadn't played it up until yesterday, and then decided
after pushing up to be able to keep track of Pabu. And if Udyr just continues to power clear, here we go, teleport behind them though.
Damage TP and Ignite there on the Braum. Not the ideal target. Flashes in for the Q, but they're still splitting damage back and forth. And Praedith finds first blood. The re-engage is still going to mean a kill. And how about the chase down though? Next time this will Sleepy Trouble.
Already completing the Gore Drinker. First Mythic. Done as well. We do have the exhaust getting pulled out.
Oh, the flash in for the auto attack, but that means a flash and an ulti is easy. Barrel, that is one of the worst plays I have seen, but it might still set up for the rest of it. The shield's not back up. The auto comes in for Ghost. I take it all back. It was the long con.
It is the second time Barrel with some pretty aggressive early flashes resulting in his death, but at least he finds his hook.
Lands this one, Paddle Stars a ton of damage. The shield is on, the Ignite seals the deal though, as Barrel walks away cleanly.
Out of the map, they've got the full top side lit up.
Yeah.
A little bit more care though.
Flash stun, Gale Force, I love it. He's cried the brush on no one. He's like, I don't even.
Second time, let's see about the pick though.
Oh, yep, Ward hops in, gets the stop, and now in the 2v1, it might just be easy. Sidesteps the Sonic Wave, but not a problem for Soul Shackles. Khan claims the kill. It could be pretty usefully on the ANZ side. Nice, the combo comes in, huge damage. He's burning down. Praedith will drop. Good setup and knockdown by a Barrel. Bit of help from Canyon, sure, but support difference there 100% of the time.
Yep, he finds the pick. You get credit for the ultimate and the hook. Really set up here on this dragon. 20 seconds ahead. Khan goes for
there
it.
There we go. We got the ward hop the kick backwards. Give him an eternal. That is a bicycle kick, according to the League of Legends official game. Client Showmaker. Oh my. Burns his flash, knocks him down. Of course, beautifully played setup there by Khan. Give big respect to Insect, the man that actually popularized the play. And now the engage continues. Lock of Shield comes in into the back line, goes Ghost, and he is gonna knock one down already. Into the graveyard goes Pabu. Now time for a bit more as, hey, they got Barrel back, but it's still a 3v4 on the map, and it's time for the rest of PGG to turn tail and run, and Decoy is gonna be sacrificed on the way out.
All right, I spy a Lucian down there. Did they have vision?
Even though he has 100% of his kills, that also means his team has none. Their KDAs look much, much worse, honestly. They're gonna try yet again now is, well, okay, easy jump back for Khan. He's gonna be safe. Bit of damage towards Barrel, puts the ulti in. A root there, they are gonna find a single kill. Culling's gonna push back a bit more damage, but now Ghost ready for the re-engage and shuts down two, nicely done. Snipe's gonna land on a Biopanther, and even though Pentanet can find a single kill, there's always two more coming back. Somewhere else. Well, the man's gonna run for his life. There's no way he actually lives. He's gonna dodge the Everfrost root. All right, the boy is dead. Thumbs up for Teemo. I know it doesn't matter. They're going for the Nexus itself. The turrets are up, and if Nexus is just one big inhibitor that keeps your whole base from dying, then that might be number two. Looking now at the defense is Pentanet, as mid lane not gonna be too terribly pushed in. In fact, it's actually hitting Dom Juan's middle outer. So it's just kind of pushing for the game. They're not going for anything bigger than this. They're not going for second lane. They're just going for the game ender. Still a minute and 8 seconds as the cannon keeps shooting in. The next wave reinforced with Baron Buffon. They're not easily killed. Big stun to the front line already to delete one. And a double stun from Nautilus is huge as they're gonna find the dive in. A nice jump backwards keeps Praedith safe as it looks to kill Canyon. Chaz already dropped down though. It's a 2 for 0. Jumping in as Canyon gets the ulti, looking to get the setup as the rest of the squad comes in, and the Canyon duo finds himself their second kill. Beautifully done for the squad, and goodbye. There is the ace, and I was right, and so was Dom Juan. They are going to be slaughtering this game. A 27-minute victory. They're gonna knock down the second Nexus turret. They're gonna knock down the Nexus itself, and right through the bottom lane, 17-5. Dom Juan Kia claim the top seed out of the Rumble stage.
Confident play there, their last step to actually secure number one spot. They get to choose their opponent.